Bless God for life and for being here. Thank God for the words of the two speakers that went before. And I want to encourage the people to listen to what is being said today.
Amen.
You know, sometimes there will be some of us that will have a favorite speaker.
Yeah.
But I wanted to forget and think about the spirit of the people.
Yeah.
And he could do that, he could go beyond your expectation, and he could go beyond your limits. This is the kind of God that we serve. So, you know, so you're looking for something from this God.
That's
it? Praise the Lord. I want to look at second line in verse 5 and just listen. You know what he said? Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. Hear what Slim said. Thou hast turned for me my mourning into dances, and thou hast put off my sackcloth and girded me with gladness. Clothing, you want to clothe you with
yes, amen, brother.
He want to take off something and put on something else. You know, so I want to thank God for your word. You know, I was listening to the mother was saying that in the sense of she was celebrating her birthday.
Yeah.
And it's something to really think about that that you could call people together to give God thanks for life. So on this special day, I want to remember who have been living.
Yeah.
So I want to celebrate by myself, you know? So I want to call people, friends and family, that we could rejoice for unto God who holding my life in his hand. It didn't please him. If it pleased him to let go of my life at death. And some of us just be really and truly afraid of God.
Yeah.
But you know, in times like these, this is a time to get in God.
Yes,
because
amen.
This is the only one who is able to keep you.
Amen.
If God was able to keep you since you was a child and then had no sense, and others had to tend to you, and was able to guide you from danger and from ups and downs, and is able to keep you and I, that we need right sense today and to understand what one another saying. If God was able and didn't need you to help him keep you alive, I believe God is able to do all things. You see, and in walking with God, we ought really ought not to be afraid, because God is able to keep you.
Yes.
You see, in John chapter 10, Jesus was trying to make the disciples understand what he meant by this. And he was telling them, he said, my sheep. He said, my sheep, right?
Yeah.
My sheep know my voice. And they will follow a stranger. And he said that the Father that is greater than all have given them to me. And here he said, nobody could pluck you out of the Father's hand. So you're telling me, if God the Father holding me, nobody can take me out of his hand?
Go on.
So I'm walking with somebody. When he put a hold on me, even if you have enemies, they can't take you out of God's hand.
No.
This is the reason why you see we have to be real. Because you see, God must be ashamed to protect you.
True.
God must be ashamed to defend you.
That's right.
God doesn't feel shame in front of you. Well, you know, I don't want to protect the brother in front of the angel. I don't want to worship like this because I'm going to look bad. God doesn't feel shame to protect you. But when we come before God, you're looking at who watching and watching you.
Yeah.
And if I go to let go myself and worship, they go say this, let us hear.
Let us say amen.
They're going to say,
God bless.
I tell you, I will worship. And I will praise. Because why? Because when I remember who holding me. And what I like about God is when you're going through your situation, you're serving a God who is able to take you out. You say weeping, weeping. You have to cry forever. When you might be in a bad situation, you might be real bad. It might have tears in your eyes now. Some people crying inside. Some people crying in secret because you can't tell others where you're going through. But weeping may endure.
For
as long as God says, what have a beginning does have an end. And everything in this world is for a time. So once you're going through a time and start, God is able to bring you out. And what I like about God, God is able to make a way for you and me when you you who on the outside and they know what they're doing. And you're watching these people suffering. And you're watching them with your hardship and sorrow. And they're making shame and they're suffering. But you just can't see the hand we're holding them because it's invisible.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
The hand we're holding them, yes. Even though they went through the trouble, it don't let go.
No.
He promised never to leave us, to forsake us, but to go with us to the end. Sometimes when you let go, God still holding on to you.
Thank you. Thank you, Jesus.
I get better for the situation. And I've been through the problem for years. And I threw my hand up in the air and said, I've done it. But the one who's holding you and taking it to me, hold on.
Yeah.
You know how to hold on.
And not let
and
go.
Guide. And if you, a friend, God will even defeat you in the presence of you. You make it joke.
Thank you, Jesus.
You see, this is the God that we're serving. This is the reason why we have to go all out to give it all. You see, watch, man. God have our ears, turn the situation around.
Amen. Yes, Jesus.
Sometimes we just put a limit on what we're going through. And you might be crying, sitting, not encouraging you. And you might be going home to the bad things that you can't tell nobody. But God have a way. He just turn your morning
into dancing, man.
And you just stick off your sackcloth and ashes when you're surviving and you're pleading. And sometimes we have one garment of grief.
Yes, grief, man.
And you're dying inside because you think bad. And when they say it's hot in there, but God have a way, he knows how to take off this garment.
Thank you.
And when he put on the garment on me, that just helped me to rejoice because it's a spiritual thing.
Yes.
So God was. So when they start to sing, I can't sing them just so.
No.
Something will start to move here because you're wearing something.
Yes.
You're wearing something that is of the Holy Ghost.
That's right.
I want to challenge anybody. When the Spirit of God moving, and if he touch you, sit down, man.
Yeah. So true.
It's something you have on.
Yeah.
And when God moves, it does move. If God gets up, you see, because there's one.
That's right.
You see. I want to encourage you because God is able to make a way for you in spite of what people think about you.
That's
what
right.
They say. You see, because why? I was reading in Revelation and they were showing us that when John saw the wonder in heaven and the woman was clothed with the sun and the moon and Jupiter, they say it had a big dragon waiting for she to make a child. And the dragon put himself in place.
Yeah.
And the dragon seen himself as soon as she made the child, I go kill it. Like when the dragon thought.
Yeah.
Like when the dragon thought. Yeah. And at times the enemy just want to set some trap for you.
Yes,
that he can take you out.
Yes.
And at times the enemy plays already, you know. But he can't do you nothing until God.
Yes,
man.
The one who holding you.
Yeah, the one who holding you, man.
And to protect you. Yeah. You see, God knows how to go around you.
Yes.
God knows how to take you through the enemy. And go over the enemy.
Yes.
And in front. And you can't see. So this is how it is. So they say that how they say when the woman make the child was called up to God. Why do you think the child out of God had?
Thank you. Can't make that.
Why do you think the child out of God had?
Can't make that.
And he was called up to God. And because the woman preferred this child, the devil decided to persecute the woman.
Hear
what I like about God in that right there.
Yeah.
The writer said that how the woman, when the devil persecuted the woman was given 2 wings as an angel. And the wings, the wings was designed to carry she in the wilderness. Not who she in the wilderness. The wings, you see, when God in control of you, imagine God made a place for the woman in a wilderness. For then you hear wilderness, you will say, well, they had no water, and they dry, and I can't survive there. God make a place in an area where you feel you can't survive.
Yes.
This is the God that we serve. And when God make the place for the woman, the woman was being designed to nourish in that same wilderness.
Yes.
He didn't look for a good place, and the dragon could find the woman while she was being nourished. You know? That's the reason why, I was trying to make it, when God hold in you, God is able to keep you in spite of who you fighting against you. You see, this is how it this be. They say when the time passed, the dragon opened him out and threw a whole river or something to wash away the woman.
Yeah.
And the writer said that when God commanded the God, the God opened him out and drink up the water. And the God helped the woman because God had it so.
Yes.
And then we serve in a God who is able to take you through things where you could never imagine.
Yes.
God promised not to put more on you than you could bear.
Yeah.
Sometimes you're going through things for a reason and a purpose. that God will tell nobody.
Yeah.
But you must pass this way.
Yes.
You must go through this way.
Yes.
So it will be real good. When you come in at Thanksgiving and you hear the Thanksgivers giving the declaration on where they was, what God bring them through, and what and where God had them today, it is because they listen what is being said. You might learn something. You see, we serve a God that is awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome.
And you might be crying now. But don't give up, eh? Time is coming just now when God is going to dry your tears.
What is this?
Just hold on a little longer. God is able to see your truth and
to
dry your tears. So I just want to encourage you. So that's why, while I have a joy in my soul,
hallelujah, I have a joy in my soul,
see you.